Does Nigeria need digital banks? Well, that's a quite a provoking question, but that's the title of a new report from Steers Data. The company is the Data Analytics and Data Advisory Division of Steers Business. In October, they launched a report focused on the digital economy, and this first edition looks at the rise of digital banking in Nigeria. Joining me in the studios now at our headquarters in Lagos to discuss this further is Uguna Iheme, advisory lead at Steers Data. Good morning.
Good morning.
Welcome.
Thank you. Take me through this.
Are digital banks becoming as valuable and invaluable part of our entire financial ecosystem as the traditional brick and mortar bank institutions?
Yes. So I think the first thing we would want to establish is that digital banks are valued differently from brick-and-mortar traditional banks. So when you're looking at digital banks, they are mostly venture-backed, tech-enabled companies. So they are valued by venture companies. And traditional banks, they are typically valued by their market capitalization on the stock exchange. So there is a difference in how they are valued. And I think what's important is also underlying that valuation method is the assumption and the perception that digital banks are going to grow much faster because they are tech-enabled, they are going to scale exponentially, and because of that, that's where a lot of this value is coming from, this perception of exponential growth and this expectation because of being venture-backed tech-enabled.
How would that change from the traditional online banking to digital banking?
So with digital banks, one easy way to look at it is that they don't have a lot of the infrastructure. They don't have to manage a lot of the infrastructure.
The physical assets
that traditional banks
have. Like ATM, for example.
Yes, that traditional banks have. So this allows them to work at a lower cost base and makes them more flexible. So if we look at Nubank in Brazil, for instance, they were able to reduce the cost of giving credits to their customers just because, not only from funds from their investors, but because they're able to work at such a low cost base.
Well, when you're talking about whether it's a brick and mortar bank or digital banks in Nigeria, folks want to talk about credit. So in terms of loans compared to deposits, is there a higher risk of default?
So there's certainly a perceived higher risk of default. I think that that's something that's correctly been identified, that people, when they look at retail customers and SME customers, there's a tendency to think they will default more than institutional customers. Whether this has been backed up by data is a different story. I think that with the success of the credit companies that we're seeing now, the Fair Monies that we're seeing.
Credit registry and all of
yes,
that.
Yes, there is a case to be made that they might not be as risky as we've perceived them to be in the past.
But again, the volume, the flow of money in terms of transactions on digital platform is exponential.
Yeah. Yeah. I think, well, first of all, even from the demand perspective, COVID has had a lot to do with that. So in COVID, we were forced, whether we trusted digital platforms or not, to use them for our services. So that has driven a lot of adoption. And we also look at the customer profile. So bank customers are changing. Younger people are digital natives, so they are going to expect a digital component of all their services, including financial services.
So we're moving into 2022 and beyond. How will things pan out between these two, the traditional banks and digital emerging digital bank in Nigeria?
Yeah. So right now, I think with digital banks, they do have a different business model and a different customer segments than traditional banks. So right now, we might not expect as much competition as you would see in a Brazil when Nubank is big enough to
I belong to the old banking system. Am I welcome in your new digital banking space?
Yes, you're welcome. Everyone is welcome to the new digital banking space. I think the approach is that with going digital, you're more flexible, so you can make innovative products for everyone.
It's about service, isn't it?
It's about service.
Thank you. It's about service. Put it there. Thank you very much. And that's Putting It Digital Way with Uguna Iheme. Thank you very much, advisory lead at Steers Data. I will keep an eye on whatever you guys are providing.
We'll
have this conversation some other time. Thank you so much for coming on Global Business Report.